This morning, I think it's this morning, you announced the Defense Innovation Advisory Board to be headed by Eric Schmidt. And it's these multiple salvos that you're firing at the Valley to embrace. And so I don't know much about it. My guess is the audience doesn't know.
I'll tell you, and I appreciate it. And it's very much in the spirit of what we're doing, which is to try to be innovative ourselves in how we conduct ourselves as a government and a Pentagon. I tell my people, think outside the five-sided box, think in new ways. And I'm hoping that through what I call the Defense Innovation Board, and this is gonna be some people that are the best technical minds who come in and once again spend a little time giving me some advice on how we can be more innovative. I'm so grateful to Eric Schmidt for his willingness to do things. And he's the perfect chairman for two reasons. First, he's somebody who obviously is brilliant and knows the innovative process very well and has demonstrated that. And second, he's willing to do it. I mean that. You can't take it for granted that people you got a lot of things to do, that he cares so deeply about this country and about this world. And he knows that you can't have everything else. You can't have freedom, you can't have innovation, you can't take care of your families, you can't have a career if there isn't security. And so somebody's got to provide security. It's a serious business. You know, it's not a game. We know that. And he is deadly serious about it, willing to spend his time. So I'm so grateful. I'm going to let him have a substantial latitude in picking the members of the other members of the board, because I want the smartest people, and then they'll travel around the world and to our bases, installations, commanders, get familiar with our problems, and tell me how we can do better ourselves. So I'm very grateful to Eric for doing this. So this is yet another way I'm trying to connect us.
Perhaps one of the most innovative or out there initiatives that you've done thus far is also one I think you announced yesterday, which I actually think is an initiative the Russians and the Chinese already had, which is called Hack the Pentagon. Talk about, because it's so cool. I mean, from our standpoint, it's such a cool idea to allow a vetted group of hackers
to attack. You're right. There are black hats out there, and this is white hats. We're trying to adopt what is a best practice. There are lots of companies that do this. And you invite people to come and attack you and find your vulnerabilities. And it's a way of kind of crowdsourcing the expertise and having access to good people rather than bad people. And you'd much rather find the vulnerabilities, and you all are experts at this, you'd much rather find the vulnerabilities in your networks in that way than by the other way, which is pilferage of information, in our case, compromise, shutdown, and so forth of our network. So we are going to have a bug bounty, first ever in the Department of Defense, and I think we'll learn something.
So you might have some of the people in the room. So are there some rules? I think one of them was you had to be a U.S. citizen. I think it was one of the ones I saw.
we do need to make sure that they're white hats, so you have to give some confidence that it's that. No, but that's pretty much it. And then there'll be the reward of having won, but also we'll have a reward also for doing this. And it's a way of using, it's an example of using best practices out there in the government. There are companies that do, they're not doing it for fun. I'm not doing it for fun. I'm doing it for utility. But it's something we wouldn't have thought of necessarily on our own. We've learned from.
But culturally, I mean, this is where I really applaud what you're doing. Culturally, for the department to sort of say, it is okay for others to tell us where we've screwed up or where something is wrong. And to, because we do that all the time. And startups, if startups don't realize in innovation what they've done wrong and then fix it quickly, they die. And so that to me is one of the great messages that you're trying to deliver.
I hope it is, because if you don't take risk and you're not willing to fail, then you're never going to get anywhere. And you all know that, and that's one of the things that's imbued in the innovative community out here. And in our, we have to try to imbue our own folks with the same kind of spirit. Go out there, look, try something new. We can't just keep doing what we're doing, because the world changes too fast. Our competitors change too fast. So it's a serious matter for us to remain open. And government does tend to be closed. The defense establishment especially just tends to be closed. And we have important reasons for doing some things secretly and so forth. But by and large, I think the more open we are, the more connected we are to the innovative community, the better we'll be at doing what our mission is.
I'd love to give you the opportunity to give the audience any call to action that you'd like to deliver.
Well, first of all, I very much appreciate the interest. I sense that, not just in this room, but people out here and people in the innovative sector are where they are because they like to do things that matter and that are consequence and that have weight. This and what the mission of my department of defense is a very consequential thing. So if you've taken an interest in it and it sparked an interest in it, thank you. Reach out to us, be a part of our, and whether you're looking at our problems and offering us a solution, whether you're offering your own commitment for a year, 6 months, we have lots of avenues for you to connect with us that you probably haven't thought of, and we're trying to think more about every day. And look for them, and I'll help you look for them. And that's what all the things that I talked about, the IUX and so on, is supposed to be exactly that kind of switchboard. And the last is, recognize that I'm determined that we meet you halfway, that this be a real dialogue and a real connection. I know we need to look ourselves in the mirror and become more innovative ourselves. So I promise you that if you take a step, we'll take a step back in the other direction. We know that we need, when you build a bridge and you start to cross that bridge, both sides need to start walking over. And I'm committed to doing that on behalf of the government. And after all, we are you. You pay us. We represent you, and our job is to protect you, and love to have your help.